Mani Padme Hum. Mani Padme Hum. Mani Padme Hum.
Greetings, Royal Lyra Nation of the Lion Kingdom of the New Lemuria. We have massive energetics flowing in through this April portal. The pulse of God is emanating from our local Solaris as we are being flooded with gamma plasma waves of 5D and beyond. The sun produced several C-class flares today, and a halo event in the form of a CME was released off the far side of the disk yesterday. We also experienced a white column of light on the Schumann charts today at an amplitude of 31 hertz. Pachamama also received a powerful activation on the Ring of Fire with a magnitude 7 earthquake in Papua New Guinea at 1804 UTC. We are being prepared to be elevated through the coming 4-4 gateway this Tuesday. This will be another major choice point and anchor for the New Earth timeline for all starseeds to ground into and bridge heaven and earth through the rainbow body of full illumination. Our Divine Holy Mother, Mariam, the Queen of the Angels, surrounds you now in her white light of healing and protection. Nothing and no one can penetrate her white field of the ray of Creator Source. The divine will of God flows through your heart and mind to assist you and our ground crew Earth Angelic Team of the 144 on our final 3D missions of consciously co-creating and transforming this realm into the paradise Gaia has always evolved to be. The gold flame of the Christos Sophia ray of transfiguration has been activated and is blazing bright in your sacred heart center. Allow the white flame of resurrection to consume all you are and release into the holy flame every thought, feeling, and emotion, and rise through the ascension spiral and into the vortex of the awakening consciousness of the luminous ones. In Buddha mind, we become the awakened beings of the pure land of bliss and enlightenment. Together, we step over the threshold of the new golden age of eternal life. Aho! Welcome, beloved beings of light. I am Paul Whitegold Eagle with PrimeDisclosure.com. We have many powerful transmissions again for you today from our sacred New Earth scribes, so be sure to listen to the very end where we release a very powerful invocation of the white flame. And please do us a favor and share this video with your teams and tribes all over this realm. And now we continue with the Sabian symbols. Right now the moon is at 7 degrees, 15 minutes Virgo. The sun is at 13 degrees, 3 minutes Aries. The current Sabian symbol for the moon at 8 degrees Virgo. A girl takes her first dancing instruction, and the current Sabian symbol for the sun at 14 degrees Aries. A serpent coiled near a man and a woman, from astrologyweekly.com. And from Divine Sistar of the Light, Valerie A. Elster. Many things landing today in the physical realm. Massive truths being revealed. Higher frequency timeline has grounded. One heart. And from Divine Sistar of the Light, Jennifer Catron. Massive timeline convergence today. Whole other group of souls in the collective made a jump to the ascension timeline, seeing it as not only initiations for those that have stepped into their divine blueprint mission, trial run of service to others, integrated level tested. For those that made the jump, they were activated and given the codes needed to stabilize the bandwidth of the ascension timeline. Today was massive for any soul on this planet. Together we remember. And from Divine Angel of the Light, Soul Light, in this shift you are going through a rebirth. With this rebirth comes a new mind, new body, new level of awareness, and a whole new reality. All of these changes must occur and be felt within prior to being seen and manifested in the outer world. Now is the time to realize that all of the above are in your energy field. Breathe, feel, commit to the shift, and see yourself morph into your fifth dimensional self. And from Divine Sis Star of the Light, Allie Ray, as we ride these powerful energetic waves and venture through these holy corridors, remember to breathe, precious hearts. Release any instinct, habit, or need to understand or create a story about anything. Simply quiet the mind, go within, let everything be. Breathe, be still, be still, be still. Commune with the innocence of being that is there within you. Within you there is magic. Love is, love is, love is. God is, God is, God is. And from Divine Sistar of the Light, Natalia Alba. Beloved ones, we are crossing the threshold to another important portal, one in which change will continue to be the only constant. March triggered the energies that are now coming in April, and that will continue for the following months. In April, we welcome the first solar eclipse of the year, and with it, the opportunity for purification, so we can rebirth into who we truly are, sovereign, free beings in charge of our lives, as Aries season reminds us. A month to ground ourselves, descending into the physical all we have previously integrated during the previous month, mastering ourselves as creators in our human plane. We too have the 4-4 portal, which is a very important one for stabilizers, as well as for all who are on a mission to anchor love and harmony, for this portal will help us restore the foundations that have been damaged for eons. A portal that coincides with the moon in Libra 2 days later will help in grounding all we have seeded during the 4-4 portal. April is an 11 universal number, a stabilizing master number that invites us to precisely master ourselves and the many things that we are still here to learn and expand, whether it is our mission or anything else that we need to master, expand, and anchor. A number that speaks of unity and of the importance of moving inward to retrieve this unity, wisdom, and personal power. This new month helps us continue with the self-illumination process that began in March, and that will lead us into a complete repatterning, retrieving wisdom and clarity for the expansion that is coming, as we are just beginning to decode all that we have been embodying, for as this year promised, we are indeed immersed in a constant change. April's energies are going to help those who wish to go deeper into their evolutionary path by offering them the strength and devotion to continue with their spiritual practices, so they can reconnect themselves with their illumined self, to receive more guidance about how to navigate through their new timeline. As Aries energies invites us to do, it is time for us to focus on the self, remembering who we are, what is our unique mission, as an individualized aspect of creation, creating unity, and becoming the natural leaders and wayshowers that we truly are, for we are just beginning to uncover the magnificence of our divine lineage. I wish you a loving and blessed April, beloved ones. Natalia Alba, StarseedSoul.com. From Divine Sistar of the Light, Patricia Cota Robles, the Angel of Resurrection is with us. Please listen if you wish to comprehend what is happening to you in this world during these tumultuous times. The path was shown some 2,000 years ago. Humanity is now positioned to embody the living Christed light. I am grateful to be here now witnessing and experiencing our transfiguration back into the image and likeness of our Father, Mother, God, and so it is. April 2nd is Palm Sunday, which is the beginning of what is called Holy Week by many Christian religions. No matter what your spiritual or religious affiliations are, Holy Week is a very powerful opportunity for all of us. We are one, and when billions of people around the world focus on God and their spiritual traditions, it creates a significant collective cup of consciousness, literally a holy grail. This provides our Father, Mother, God, and the company of heaven with the ability to greatly intensify their infinite light on earth, thus blessing every facet of life. We are still experiencing the influx of light from the March equinox and the birth of spring in the Northern Hemisphere, which is celebrated by people around the world. Now on Thursday, April 6th, we'll be blessed with the Passover full moon, which is acknowledged by both Jews and Christians. Then on Easter Sunday, April 9th, billions of people will focus on the resurrection of Jesus and the divine gift of the resurrection flame. Because of our Father, Mother, God's newly balanced and elevated masculine and feminine holy breath, which is now flowing through every person's heart flame with every single breath we take. Humanity's spiritual focus of attention this week has formed an extraordinarily powerful chalice of light. Through this collective cup of humanity's consciousness, our God parents are now encoding into every newly balanced and elevated holy breath we take a divine intelligence that is capable of discerning and revealing to each of us the experiences, beliefs, attitudes, fears, thoughts, feelings, words, and actions we are utilizing to support obsolete belief systems that conflict with the truth of our oneness with all life. This divine intelligence is exposing the illusion of our separation from God and any of our beliefs or actions that reflect a lack of reverence for all life. Now, as this divine intelligence within the holy breath of our Father, Mother, God registers in every person's conscious mind, we are beginning to truly know that every human being is divine. Regardless of how far his or her behavior patterns and life experiences may be from reflecting that truth. This is a vitally important realization in humanity's resurrection and ascension process. Our thoughts and feelings are creative, and whatever we focus our attention on, we empower and bring into form. The divine intelligence that is now being encoded within every person's holy breath during Holy Week is providing our Father, Mother, God, and mighty solar archangel, known as the Angel of Resurrection, with the ability to enlighten humanity and to intensify the frequencies of the Mother of Pearl resurrection flame that are now bathing the earth. The frequency of this sacred fire is being amplified beyond anything humanity has ever been able to assimilate at a cellular level. Focus your attention and you will experience the profound truth that our Father, Mother, God, and the Angel of Resurrection are now breathing this awesome, restorative, and rejuvenating frequency of the resurrection flame through our heart flames, breath by breath. This sacred fire is simultaneously being infused into our planetary grid of comprehensive divine love for the benefit of all humanity, the elemental kingdom, and Mother Earth. Today, the company of heaven wants all of us to have a greater understanding of this incredibly merciful gift from our Father, Mother, God. Please listen to these words with an open heart and mind. This is the miracle of the resurrection flame. Eons ago, when the sons and daughters of God began experimenting with our gift of life and departing from the love-based qualification of our creative faculties of thought and feeling, our Father, Mother, God perceived the shadow of our miscreations taking form in the consciousness of our earthly bodies. They knew the fruits of those seeds would be aging, disease, disintegration, and decay. They further understood that some means of restoration would have to be provided to the children of earth, who would one day desire to return to our original God estate. To begin the process of manifesting that restorative power, our Father, Mother, God breathed into their heart flames from the very core of creation the radiance of the Mother of Pearl resurrection flame. This sacred fire is a multifaceted and multidimensional frequency of light by which the aged, diseased, distorted, and disintegrating carbon-based substance generated by the misuse of humanity's thoughts and feelings can be purified, restored, rejuvenated, and resurrected back into its original God perfection. When all was in readiness, our Father Mother God summoned a mighty solar archangel from the great silence to bring this sacred restoring flame to earth. Through the heart flame of this mighty archangel, who is now known through all creation as the Angel of Resurrection, the Mother of Pearl Resurrection Flame was anchored on earth. From that moment forth, the Angel of Resurrection has accepted the responsibility of bathing the earth in the resurrection flame, in a rhythmic momentum. The sacred fire flows through the portal formed during the March equinox every year and bathes the earth for several weeks. In the northern hemisphere, the resurrection flame is the frequency of light that awakens the hibernating animals and brings the plants and trees back to life after the dormant winter months. The resurrection flame is also the sacred fire from the heart of God that resurrected Jesus' crucified carbon-based planetary body into his fifth-dimensional crystalline-based solar light body. This occurred 3 days after the crucifixion on what Christians now celebrate as Easter Sunday. What the Company of Heaven wants us to remember today is how the resurrection flame can assist each of us during this global opportunity with the divine alchemy of transfiguring our own carbon-based planetary bodies into fifth-dimensional crystalline-based solar light bodies. Jesus' resurrection was a deliberate demonstration of what occurs when our carbon-based third and fourth dimensional bodies are transfigured into fifth dimensional crystalline-based solar light bodies. The scriptures state that when Mary Magdalene came to Jesus' tomb and he appeared to her, he said, "Do not touch me, I am not of this world." Jesus appeared to Mary in his fifth dimensional crystalline solar light body. Even though his carbon-based physical body had been brutalized and crucified, his fifth-dimensional crystalline solar light body was pulsating with the vibrant health and physical perfection of his I Am presence. 40 days after Jesus' resurrection into his fifth-dimensional crystalline solar light body, he demonstrated what the next step of our ascension process is going to be by publicly ascending up the spiral of evolution into the fifth-dimensional realms of light. This is the same path that humanity and Mother Earth are now in the process of completing as we move through the final stages of our ascension onto the fifth-dimensional new Earth. Jesus knew that initially we would not comprehend the full meaning of what he was demonstrating through his crucifixion, resurrection, and ascension. Nevertheless, he was determined to leave those archetypes so that in divine timing, the Company of Heaven would be able to reveal to humanity the true meaning of the divine alchemy we were destined to experience after the shift of the ages. When we complete the resurrection and ascension process we are now going through, we will not need to die in order to be resurrected from our grossly contaminated carbon-based earthly bodies. Our process is slower than what Jesus experienced because instead of one person resurrecting their carbon-based bodies and ascending into the fifth dimension, this time every person on this planet, the elemental kingdom and Mother Earth herself are going through this divine alchemy. Our I Am presence is actually accelerating this process the maximum that we can withstand in every 24-hour period. That means quite literally that day by day as we resurrect our carbon-based bodies and ascend into higher frequencies of the fifth dimension, we are taking Mother Earth and all life evolving upon her with us. This is a tremendous responsibility for every son and daughter of God on earth. But what a glorious opportunity for each and every one of us to be the instruments of God we have been preparing to be for lifetimes. Due to the urgent need of the hour, our Father, Mother, God have granted the Angel of Resurrection permission to breathe unprecedented frequencies of the Mother of Pearl Resurrection Flame into our planetary grid of comprehensive divine love. This monumental amplification of the resurrection flame is quickening the vibratory rate of humanity's, the elemental kingdoms, and Mother Earth's contaminated carbon-based cells. This is allowing our I Am presence to greatly expand the crystalline white flame of purity, pulsating within the core of purity in every electron of our earthly bodies. Breath by breath, the flame of purity is now expanding within the 50 trillion cells in our earthly bodies and the 100 trillion atoms within each cell. Our I Am presences and our silent watchers and our body elementals are now able to cast the gross shadows cloaking the electrons in our carbon-based bodies into the violet flame. Instantaneously, these shadows are being transmuted back into their original perfection. This is clearing the way for each of our cells to be resurrected so that they can safely assimilate the full divine potential of God's fifth dimensional crystalline solar light. Day by day, as we invoke and freely partake of the gifts and blessings of the resurrection flame, we avail ourselves of its restorative and rejuvenating power by stating the following decree on a regular basis. Each of us will greatly accelerate the divine alchemy taking place within our earthly bodies. Please listen to your heart and recite this decree as often as you are inspired to do so. It is a gift from on high that has been building in momentum for millennia. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the resurrection and the life of the immaculate concept of humanity's, the elemental kingdoms, and Mother Earth's fifth dimensional crystalline solar light bodies now made manifest and sustained through the holy breath of God. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the resurrection and the life of the immaculate concept of humanity's, the elemental kingdoms, and Mother Earth's fifth dimensional crystalline solar light bodies, now made manifest and sustained through the holy breath of God. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the resurrection and the life of the immaculate concept of humanity's, the elemental kingdoms, and Mother Earth's fifth dimensional crystalline solar light bodies now made manifest and sustained through the holy breath of God. And so it is. Dear one, I wish you a glorious holy week. Ask your I Am presence and the Angel of Resurrection for assistance during this amazing time, and the floodgates of heaven will open on your behalf. Patricia Cota Robles from eraofpeace.org. And from Divine Sis Star of the Light Karen Lithica, Mother Mary, love and support as the feminine healing frequencies radiate our world. Feel your heart opening to the higher light frequencies, a deeper resonance of compassion, guidance, and support. Know Mother Mary is closely aligned to our universal light mission, a shining light in the higher realms, to assist humanity and guide all living beings. I invite you to ask for guidance from Mother Mary, for the angelic light realms are all connected in light. As we connect to the angelic light realm, Mother Mary is aligned to this vibrational calling, for it is simply aligning your light body, expanding your heart consciousness to feel the myriad of light beings with you. Day by day, you come to realize your interdimensional light family are immersed in your world, your true friends as you endure this reality, to continue opening, rising your light, an ambassador of the new earth light. Infinite blessings for your day as we awaken to light, freedom, and the angelic realms. From KarenLithica.com. And from Hera and the Moon Astrology, Sunday, April 2nd, 2023, Electric Fire. As the first of the annual three spiritual festivals approaches on April 6th, the cycle of the year renews itself in Aries. In the Northern Hemisphere, the first full moon of spring marks the solar Aries festival when light returns to Earth. As poet Dylan Thomas wrote so beautifully, this is the force that through the green fuse drives the flower. Easter, Istra, is celebrated by many as a time of new hope, new life, a resurrection of the spirit. Esoterically, Aries, the first sign working on the first ray of will and power, manifests the impulse of electric fire, destroying the past, clearing the way for the future, establishing a new pattern for the following 12 months. The full moon at 16 degrees Libra arrives on Thursday, April 6th. The Aries-Libra polarity is the relationship axis, where Aries represents self and Libra represents the other. Aries is about self-assertion, Libra about compromise. This polarity is where the deeply personal interfaces with the entirely impersonal, where you, with your need to be loved, welcomed, and accepted, encounter others with completely different agendas. Expect relationship epiphanies, wake-up calls, and relationship dramas. As Awakener Uranus aspects both the Sun and Moon while Jupiter and Chiron conjunct the Sun, create win-win relationships by compromising, negotiating, and balancing. Ask for feedback and make the changes. Find ways to meet your personal needs whilst attending to the needs of significant others. Develop flow between independence, autonomy, and dependence, codependence. A heads up, the Aries new moon in 2 weeks on April 20th is a rare hybrid solar eclipse at 29 degrees Aries, which begins as an annular ring of fire eclipse and transitions into a sky darkening total eclipse. It is the first eclipse with the note of fate in Aries since 2006. And starts a whole series of wild card eclipses across Aries and Libra between now and March 29th, 2025. From here on the moon astrology.co.uk. And from Divine Sistar of the Light, Leah Whitehorse. Venus in Taurus, semi-sextile Jupiter in Aries. Mars in Cancer, sextile North Node in Taurus. With today's connection between Venus and Jupiter, hearts expand. Here is the spirit of generosity, coins dropped into the collection box, items donated to the charity shop, a smile for all who cross our path. This aspect also tells us that if you want greater security, believe in yourself. It's okay to dare to ask for more. It's okay to indulge now and then. Yes, it's a hard world out there, so it's even more important to spread a little joy where we can. With Mars now engaging with the North Node, there's also a sense that doors are opening. A small push and a dash of bravery means we can walk right through to the next chapter. This is the time to step forward and show your leadership skills. Clarify your goals and then take action. Team up with a family member to strengthen your resolve. Power yourself up with visions of victory. What you do now affects the unfolding future. Sow seeds and water them with loving intention. From LeahWhitehorse.com. And today from the Dzogchen Times, Keen 59, Blue, Resonant Storm. The number 7 is called Resonant and its keywords are channel, inspire, and attune. The 7th day is all about using your intuition to guide you further on your mission. This wave spell of the Red Skywalker is all about adventures and getting out of your comfort zone. Well, today you can resonate more with this energy if you tune in. Be prepared to receive messages via dreams or happenstance. Don't disregard their significance. They may be vital clues. Today is Blue Storm and its keywords are catalyze, energy, and self-generation. Stormy days blow in the changes and can be quite disruptive. Sometimes that's what it takes to move forward, so don't resist it. Harness this intense energy and make big changes in your life. As it is a resonant day, using your intuition will help you understand what changes to make. And today, from Divine Sistar of the Light, Christina Papagiorgio, Blue Resonant Storm, 7 Kawak, Keen 59, 2nd of April 2023, Attuning to Transformation, From Dark to Delight, High Magic Happens. 2/4/2023 equal 2/4/7 equal 2/11 equal 2/2 equal 4. 2/2 Twins Portal. Day codes 2 Twins Partner Cooperation Duality. 4 Form Structure Foundation Earth Angelic. Month Year codes 4. 11 Portal Gate Polarity Illumination. 2. 20 The Awakening Clear Vision. 23 Royal Star of the Lion Strength Protection Support. Keen 59 equal 14 equal 5. Liberation. A very powerful magical portal day is on its way, seeking to liberate our planet. The storm is here. Viva la revolution. The thunder beings have arrived. Boom. Change happens. Day 7 in the Red Skywalker Wave Spell of Awakening to our true selves through exploration and expansion. Today we are clearing out all the emotional debris to create more space for the light to enter. Tone of Creation, Resonant Tone 7 in the Emotional Realm, Action Inspires Power Channel Essence Attunement. The resonant tone very powerfully ignites the cleansing and transformational potentials today as it provides the ability to fine-tune and channel the magical forces. Remember that it is our vibration that will energize our creation and that this is broadcast through our emotional body rather than our mental body. So it is very important that we are stable, calm, and receptive to our feelings and what frequencies we are actually emitting as a transmitter to the etheric realm. At tone 7, our vibrating phenomenon learns to be still and to listen. Mystical 7 understands that everywhere is magical, but right here is better. Once we attune and then channel the magic through this present moment that is available to us all. Number 7 is also the frequency of the mystic and the magician, giving us double the magic today with the magic monkey in the higher self guide position. Much magic is afoot, dear star blessed sons. What are you attuned to today? What type of life are you generating to liberate and express your true self? Today's question is, what debris can I magically transform in order to attune to higher forces and create space for more light to enter? How can I use my innate magic to catalyze tremendous beneficial change in my life? Divine blessings for the cathartic cleansing today. May the storm bless our planet with multidimensional rainbows. Happy travels, adventurers. In la ketch a la keen. Christina White Magnetic World Bridger, Keen 66. Keen 59, Blue Resonant Storm. The mantra, the code for today is, I channel in order to catalyze inspiring energy. I seal the matrix of self-generation. With the resonant tone of attunement, I am guided by the power of magic. And on this powerful day of activations, transformations, and manifestations, let us know, beloved beings of light, in the comments below what you're feeling, what you're seeing, your dreams, your visions, and your synchronicities. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and click the subscribe button below and the little bell to get notifications on future updates. And as always, we have a link in the description below to the transcriptions of today's transmissions, and we archive these on our website, primedisclosure.com. Now I'd like to take the time to thank everyone supporting us in our work and mission. It's because of your monthly pledges and donations we're able to continue this work. So if you'd like to help support our work, our mission, and help us continue bringing these daily transmissions to the world, you can either make a monthly pledge or a one-time donation. All the links are at egolovecondor.com. Now I'd like to welcome and thank Divine Sistar of the Light, Michelle Webb, for your pledge and support on YouTube memberships, and welcome to the tribe of the Eagle and the Condor. I'd like to also thank Divine Angel of the Light, Delta Dawn, for your Super Thanks donation today. Thank you very much. We appreciate you and your support. And I'd like to also thank Divine Brother of the Light, Kevin Wise, for your Super Thanks donation. Thank you very much, Divine Brother. We appreciate you and your support. Now I'd like to also thank everyone supporting my Sacred Condor's artwork. You could purchase her beautiful handmade goddess totem, zodiac goddesses, healing jewelry, and other works of art at lunagoddessart.com. Now we're going to complete today's transmissions with a very powerful invocation from Divine Sistar of the Light, Emily Kate, from A Light from Albion. Invocation of the White Flame. The White Flame can be called with the assistance of Archangel Gabriel, Archangel Hope, Serapis Bay. It is a good flame for the colder winter months in the Northern Hemisphere. The White Flame can be called to enhance purity, discipline, and harmony in one's life. Serapis Bey, an ascended master who came through Luxor, Egypt, taught students how to ascend to higher consciousness and higher dimensions through a path of discipline that included many steps, including placing oneself in difficult situations with difficult people in order to find harmony in any situation. This was one of the tasks an initiate in his plan would have to fulfill. Archangel Gabriel, known as the Messenger of God, assists many beings who are on the ascended master path, including his assistance to Yeshua, Jesus, and Mikael in their incarnations here on Gaia. All of us humans with souls have been born into Gaia through one of the divine rays of light. Understanding which ray one comes through will help you find your soul family. I invite the white flame from the divine to enter my being and my life. May Archangel Gabriel, Hope, and Ascended Master Serapis Bey assist me in bringing the white flame into my life. Blessings, Emily Kate, Ashnia Allah. Thank you for joining us today, beloved beings of light. Have a most beautiful and blessed week ahead, a most powerful 4-4 portal into the full moon on Thursday, the 6th of April. Keep walking gently your sacred path with heart, with peace and love in every step, and keep shining your light brightly into the night. Be sure to make this day and every day the best day ever. The Eagle and the Condor love you all. Namaste.